Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to create a Windows 7 bootable flash drive with Rufus. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to use Rufus to create a bootable Windows 7 flash drive, you can follow this guide and I'll have all of the links available in my written guide, and you can find a link to that in the description of this video. Now before we start, you'll need a 16 gig or more USB flash drive. It's essential. Preferably one that's blank or one that you can format that you don't mind deleting the data on. And then you also need the Windows 7 ISO file, which you can download by following my other guide. So if you have a look at my desktop here, I've got this Windows 7 Service Pack 1 64-bit ISO file. And if you go to my channel, you're gonna find this video that I recently uploaded showing you how to download Windows 7 in 2024. And in this guide, I also show you how to create a bootable flash drive with Windows 7 on it, but I don't show you how to do that using Rufus. And that's why I'm creating this guide. But you'll need the Windows 7 ISO file, and you can get it by following this guide. And I'll also link this video in the description of the video that you're watching now. But once you have that ISO file, the next thing that you'll need is Rufus. And you can just download that by going to Google. And then you can do a search for Rufus download. Then the best result should be the Rufus webpage. You can go ahead and click on that. And then on this page, if you scroll down, you're gonna find this Rufus Standard Edition. You can just click on that to start the download. If you're prompted to save it, just choose your downloads folder and then click on save. It's gonna download Rufus. And once it's finished, you can just click on it to open it. And once it's open, the first thing that you're going to need to do is you'll need to plug in your flash drive. So I've just gone ahead and done that, and you can see that it's picked up my 16 gig flash drive. So go ahead and plug in your flash drive. And then next you need to make sure that disk or ISO image is selected. Then click on select. And then you need to navigate to where you have the Windows 7 ISO file saved, which should be on your desktop if you followed my other guide. So you can go ahead and select that, then click on open. For the image option, you can leave this on standard Windows installation, but for the partition scheme, I recommend that you change this to MBR so that it can boot in a legacy BIOS system. If you create this Windows 7 flash drive as GPT, I'm pretty sure that you're gonna have some issues booting from it. So for this guide, just set it to MBR, and then the volume label, I'm just gonna set this as Windows 7. And you can leave all of these other settings on default, and you can just click on start. You might get some prompts with regards to the flash drive being in use. You can just click on yes, and then you'll see this message that says the data on it will be deleted. You can just click on OK, and then Rufus will start creating the Windows 7 bootable flash drive with the ISO file that we selected. So you can just wait for this to finish and you'll be able to boot from this flash drive and then install Windows 7. But remember, if you try and install Windows 7 on a newer system or basically anything later than a 6th gen Intel CPU system, you're gonna have some issues with drivers and all of that. So it's best to just use Windows 7 and this flash drive to recover or repair an old Windows 7 computer that you have. Once Rufus is done, you're gonna see that the status here turns to ready. And you can go ahead and close Rufus then. And if you open up your File Explorer and then go to this PC, you should have your Windows 7 bootable flash drive. And you can now go ahead and you can turn off your computer, or you can just plug the flash drive into the computer that you want to boot from. And then go ahead and choose the legacy boot option and then continue with the Windows 7 installation. But that's it for this guide, and I hope you found value from this video. If you did, please give it a like, and I'll talk to you guys soon.